OpenIPC and RubyFPV are technologies gaining popularity in the FPV world. While the technology is complex, what matters the most is that it's all open source and developed by passionate enthusiasts. OpenIPC and some big companies like Runcam and Emacs have released several devices for VTX or video transmitter, but the VRX or video receiver still remains primarily a DIY project. In this video, I'll demonstrate how even a complete beginner like me can build a working VRX and run RubyFPV on it. A quick disclaimer, I'm not an electrical engineer, so there's definitely room for improvement in my build. If you spot any way to enhance this setup, please share it in the comments below. It's very easy to damage the electronics. I've already broke two Wi-Fi cards, so yeah, just be careful with them. Okay, let's talk about the design. I'm pretty new to FPV world and I don't own any goggles yet, so I needed a solution that could display the video stream. You can use your phone with OpenIPC, which I've done before, but the problem is that you can't display Ruby on it. So I came up with this design that basically the whole device attaches to the back of my radio, and the display bracket here is being held up by this custom bracket that I've designed. And you can tilt the screen using this GoPro connection. On the back of the display bracket, you have these rails that are used to attach the VRX. The whole thing is modular, so I can take it apart if I want to. The whole reason I went with this design is basically I want to be able to see my plane just in case I crash, which happened a few times. It just gives me peace of mind. You have this on-off switch here. There is a hidden display here that shows you the voltage. It shines the light through the case, so it's only visible when you power the device on. And overall, I'm pretty happy with the design, how it turned out. The VRX also runs on 18650 cells in series with two step-down DC converters, providing 5 volts to all the components. A RADSA 3W single-board computer runs RubyFPV, while two RTL 8080-12EU2 modules capture the VTX signal. A 5-position switch handles Ruby menu navigation, and you'll need some screws and some heat inserts for the assembly. I've also included a 5-volt 25mm fan, though it might not be essential. Future improvements could include adding a battery management system for charging the cells. If you'd like to build this design yourself, you'll find all the links to parts and 3D print files in the description below. Some of those links can be affiliate, so I get a little bit of money if you do end up buying those components. Okay, let's get started. Now the first step in your build is 3D printing all the components. I've done the hard work of prototyping, so everything should fit nicely. There's nothing special about the 3D printing. Well, maybe except for the boxer bracket. It needs to have 4 wall layers, 25 infill, and it needs to be printed on the backside, as shown in the clip, is for the strength. You will also need to print the lid and some buttons. Okay, let's now talk about all the parts you need. There is the body, the lid, two Wi-Fi cards, two DC converters, a USB hub, the digital voltmeter, antenna connections, the RADSA single board computer, 5-volt fan, battery tray, 5-way switch, some capacitors, a small on-off switch, and some antennas. Oh, and you'll also need some hardware, like the heat inserts and the bolts. You will also need a USB-C male connector, which is not shown here, and some 20 gauge wire. The next thing I like to do is take all the components and just dry fit it in the enclosure. This is to make sure everything fits and there's, you know, no problems with fitment or anything. So if everything fits nicely, set your soldering iron to a temperature about 10 degrees higher than the melting temperature of your filament that you use for printing enclosure. Use the tip to push the heat inserts inside. The next step is to wire everything together. You can use this diagram as well as the information that's found on Ruby website. Here you can see some of the components already installed and pre-wired. One thing you need to be careful about is connecting the Wi-Fi modules. So here you can see on the right hand side the pinout diagram, and on the bottom you have numbers from 1 to 8. On the number 8, for example, if you refer to the table on the right, this is the ground connection, but then 7 and 6 are 5 volt. Do not short these two. So if you short them, you're gonna break the board. And that's it for this build video. I hope you learned something, I definitely did along the way. Some amazing OpenIPC developers and I are working on a new device to make building a VRX way easier. So if you don't want to miss it, subscribe. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.